happens, I don't support any investment in Zimbabwe right now. Because anyone who is doing so is perpetuating human rights violence, perpetuating human rights violations. So it's only a few who can then invest their money into Zimbabwe. Because Zimbabwe is not ready for any investment. For investment to be okay in Zimbabwe, we need one, the respect of rule of law. Number two, we need investor confidence. No investor can have confidence in a country or in an economy which is against its own citizens, in a country that does not have its own currency. So how are they going to invest in Zimbabwe? Zimbabwe is not ready for investment. If anything, the World Economic Forum should chastise Zimbabwe so that Zimbabwe must go back to the drawing board. As long as the issue of the legitimacy of the president is not addressed in Zimbabwe, Zimbabwe will never be ready for any investment. We are being led by a government that is a thuggery government. We are being led by people who have specialized in thieving. We are being led by people who are specializing in killing their own brothers. We are being killed by the very same army that is supposed to be protecting us. So we cannot say in a country that has got so much institutionalized violence that any investor then must go and invest in Zimbabwe. If anything, what has happened in Zimbabwe in the past 2 months should be a call for anyone in this world to make sure that Zimbabwe is put under sanctions, not these targeted sanctions.
The guys on the other side from ZANU-PF are suggesting that there's been an atmosphere of lawlessness, of anarchy in Zimbabwe, and that you can't build anything without peace, without any stability in Zimbabwe. What is your view on that, and what would your response be?
They are the perpetrators of violence. Since 1980, violence is known to be coming from ZANU-PF. They issued violence against Joshua Nkomo. At one time, he had to flee the country disguised as a woman. We don't know where Rashiwe Kuja and Kempton Tlela are. That is what happened in the 1980s. We go on to the 1990s, when the launch of the MDC, I can sing without Chawana Mabiga and Talent Chimwe. They were patrol bombed and killed in their own vehicle by the same regime. Morgan Tsvangirai at one time suffered violence against ZANU-PF. We are today, as we are speaking, with people like a week ago, the Midlands Youth Secretary for the MDC, Sekai Marasha, was abducted. She's a lady, was abducted by 8 armed men and left for dead. We haven't seen a single person from ZANU-PF or a single violence report from ZANU-PF. Of late, we have seen yesterday Kitungwiza mayor was beaten by ZANU-PF thugs. 2 weeks ago, the Bulawayo deputy mayor was beaten by ZANU-PF thugs. So what they are saying is the fallacy. Of course, they are there to prop up their regime because they are benefiting financially. They are the people who benefited from the chaotic land reform. So they are protecting their own interests. But for them to say there is no rule of law in Zimbabwe, that is an indictment on Mnangagwa himself. It means the center is no longer holding. It means Mnangagwa has failed to hold that country.
I'm also trying to thank the SADC leadership for a bold step in regards to the fight against the illegal sanctions that were imposed on Zimbabwe. And also to say, Comrade President, we know you have a very hard task at hand in trying to resolve the economic challenges that is facing our country. So we are coming out to say we support you. We understand that it's not going to be an event. It's a journey, a long one, which requires us to support you in totality. So we came here, the 10 of us, as part of the national leadership, to support our guys from Cape Town.
We are here to say, fine, as Zimbabwe, we have challenges, basically economic challenges, which have to be addressed. But these require national unity on the part of all Zimbabweans. They cannot be resolved on partisan lines, which is why our president initiated a dialogue for all the political players. So basically, we are here to send a message, say no, we are in support of our president. Yes, we are in difficulties, but we are very much confident that he is in the right track and he's doing everything within his means to make sure that those problems that we face are resolved.
So, I get your point and I get why you're here. So you didn't come here violently, as a violent protest, because there's been reports, people are saying lots of things about the ongoing xenophobic attacks. So I that inside that you guys were here for that, but now I'm here. But so you're not here for that today.
No, no, we don't believe in violence as an institution. We believe in peace. ZANU-PF is on its log. There is unity, there is peace, there is development. If there are any challenges, we believe in mutual dialogue. So we are happy that our president is the chairman of the Central Troika on politics, defense, and security. He is around. So we believe that as much as there are challenges here in terms of these attacks, we don't believe in confrontation. We believe in engagement. And we think it is the rightful opportunity for our president to talk to his colleague, comrade Cyril Ramaphosa, so that the South African government can find a way to resolve these challenges that we continue to face here in South Africa.
If I may take this chance, as political leadership, like as you are in the leadership of the youth league, so what's your take on that, and how do you think that matter could be resolved?
No, no, we believe that in Africa we are one. Fine, we have these boundaries which were imposed on us by the colonizers, and we don't think it's necessary for us as Africans to continue to pay attention to the colonial borders. We believe in being one. Even if South Africans have genuine concern to say these foreign nationals are doing 1, 2, 3, we don't think they must attack us. I think there is room for engagement. Whatever that they think we are not doing right, we are ready to say, okay, fine, let's have adjustments, let's come to a compromise, tell us what you want, so that at least we continue to coexist. We don't believe in retaliation, we don't believe in attacking anyone. We believe in coexistence, in dialogue, and unity as a black people, as Africa.
Not safe in this country.